Series last year. And here's how the starting lineups shape up. Jordan Ainsley, Charlie Kingham, George Chatterton up front for England. Fergus Geary, Will Edwards, who's one of the few players that's appeared on the World Series. Charlie Spofforth and Callum Sirka, who is absolute wheels. Look out for him in the eighth shirt. For Uganda, well, Philip Wakarach is an absolute superstar in Uganda, the number five. Watch out for him. Eric Kasita, the captain. And Ramathan Govle will help them win ball up front. And this Ugandan side, coached by Talbot Onyango, really can't be underestimated, especially Rob Vickerman. But Simon Amell's brought such a young English side here to Munich.
They have indeed, very young English team. No excuses, their infrastructure is far greater than this Ugandans. Heavily favourites going into this game, irrelevant of experience. But one thing is for sure, there is one player that could completely dominate this game, and it is Philip Wakarach, the Ugandan number five. He scored some incredible tries on the World 7 Series. Seven tries for a team that didn't particularly do that well is something to note. His kick and chase in particular is always something to witness.
Eric Kasita, the captain, holds the ball aloft, Fiji style, and they surround him. A show of togetherness from the Cranes, as the Uganda rugby team is known. And here's England. They come together for a couple of final words. Referee for this one is Craig Evans from Wales.
Nothing we can do about it.
Very experienced Sevens referee these days as well. Yeah, no doubt keep a firm grip on this one.
Yes, yes.
So there's Callum Sirka.
Yeah, buddy, very quiet.
One of these England players with World Series experience.
Yeah, yeah, I got you.
I reckon he's faster than Dan Norton in a straight line. Not sure Norton agrees with that, but that's what we're hearing. So England no doubt try and get him the ball in space. And we are underway here. In Pool B, short kickoff from England, but it's been brought down by Uganda. That's Adrian Kasito. And there's Philip Wakarach in the five shirt that Rob Vickerman was talking about. Do watch out for him. He does make things happen. Going to ground there is James Odongo. In Uganda, they did appear at the Dubai Cape Town Sevens last year and also that Hong Kong qualifying event. We'll go through the phases here, try and test this England defence. Big couple of weeks this for Uganda. Sevens rugby as the ball goes to floor. Wakarach has found an opening. It's Fred Odoh who's out there to Odongo. And on the far side, that's Kasita, the captain. He's brought down by Sirka, last line of defence. Good start this from the Africans. Putting it through the hands is Kasita again. Offloading off the floor, Ramathan Govle. England trying to keep their line of defence nice and straight here, moving up in a wall together. Trying to step through the line is Wakarach. Kasito decides to go the other way. Stepping inside with some power and pace is Fred Odoh, and he is through. Odoh does it for Uganda. What a step and what a turn of pace. He has shocked England here. Great try.
One thing you're always going to get is a brilliant celebration. The Ugandans loving every single minute of it and playing some wonderful sevens. I made that seven widths of play. Passing the ball accurately, which is something you don't often say about Ugandan team, but taking people on. The fatigue builds up, as we'll always say in the game of sevens. Every single width you run, you accrue more and more pain in your legs. And he is not happy looking on there, Simon. I'm not going to lip read, but he's not best pleased with his team.
One, two, three, it's all about me. Conversion successful. Uganda lead England by 7 points to nil. And we are back underway. Charlie Spofforth getting back there for England. We'll try and launch an attack. Here's Sirka. Buys himself a little bit of time. In the headgear there is Charlie Spofforth. He gives it off to Charlie Kingham. Nice offload. And here come England trying to get their attacking game together. This is much better. Deep into Ugandan territory now, but just got a little bit isolated. Uganda almost won the turnover, but just a little knock on. But perhaps England not getting close enough to the ball carry there.
Exactly that, Coach Cox. Your second player must be there in a split second. They talk about threes in the game of sevens. The ball carrier, the first man to clear, the person to clear away. If you're not there quick enough, you will get turned over all day long. Wonderful tackling. Not quick enough there from England.
Let's get set first, bro. Charlie, get set first. Tight.
So Uganda haven't missed the tackle yet.
Crouch. Bind.
But it is England that have the attacking set. Scrum. And they've got a very deep attacking line stretched all the way out to Callum Circa on the near side. Perhaps it's to the pace of Circa they will go. Finding a gap through the middle. Fergus Geary has gone to ground, but it's been picked up by Will Edwards, the captain. Little stutter step, and Edwards is in. Oh, that was smartly done from the England skipper. Little hitch kick, got away from the defender, and England have responded.
Good play from the England team, always wonderful to see. Will Edwards going well, really confident player. Added a lot of value to the England team last year, played in four tournaments, so was there thereabouts for a few as well. Support play, as ever, from these types of players, the playmakers sniffing around opportunity.
Yeah,
kick down that left-hand side, lovely finish.
Who has the conversion responsibilities, and he bounces that in off the right hand upright. So it's seven apiece here in Pool B. Will Edwards made his World Series debut in Vancouver earlier this year, an event that England went on to win, beating South Africa in the final. One of two events that England won on the World Series last time out. Also took out the Cape Town event, also against South Africa, and they've won it back from the restart, England. Through the hands of Fergus Geary again. And here's George Chatterton. Head gets flung to the floor there. He gets up off the floor, no problem. And England will come to the near side once more. It's Charlie Kingham, almost through Philip Wokarach. Going in for the turnover there is Casito. And he's won it. So well done from Casito, winning the ball back for his team. We're inside the... just outside the last 90 seconds of this first half. Seven apiece. Fred Odoo got the try, scoring starter for Uganda, but that pass has gone forward and it's an opportunity for England. Here's Edwards again, decides to switch play.
Rock, leave, Red, leave!
And they've got some space over on the far side, England. Through the hands of Chatterton to Circa. Comes off his right foot, does Callum Circa, and then puts the hammer down, and Callum Circa shows his pace. That's what they've been talking about. If he sees a gap, he's got the wheels to take him through.
The swagger of the man as he does what he knows he can. Bounces off the right foot, steps back inside, keeps pace. That's what's important here. He's changing direction, but he's maintaining his pace. It's what all wingers are blessed with. Balance and poise, a good finish from Circa. Certainly backs himself, doesn't he?
Well, that's what you want from your pace, man.
Let's go.
Take the bull by the horns. Get the job done. Good try from Callum Circa. And England are in front by 12 points to 7. Here's another look at it.
Not much on. Floating around the outside. Gone through three players he's beaten there on that inside line. Really good play. When you get your wingmen able to come in field to spot opportunities, that's when you know they're playing with confidence.
So Simon Amor will no doubt be a little more pleased than we saw him earlier on in this first half after conceding the opening try. It was a fairly soft try to concede as well, it's got to be said, from a team of this resource. And the amount of time they have together. Good tackle from Circa on the far side to back up his try. Uganda will look to get some more points before the break. Final play we're on. Long floating pass out here to Govlate. Steps inside of Jordan Ainslie. Wokarach. Been quiet in this first half so far, Philip Wokarach. Keep an eye on him at number five. Can always make something out of nothing. Here's Odoo, the try scorer again on the wraparound. Casita. Tries the dummy, but Edwards doesn't fall for it. And that's a good turnover for England. Really stand-up tackle from Will Edwards, the captain. And they'll go quickly. England not settling for the break here. And the lead they have, 12-7. Charlie Spofforth offloads to Edwards. Chatterton. Here come England again. It's Charlie Kingham. He's wrapped up ball and all. Going into play scrum half is Fergus Geary again. Chance on the far side. It's Serka again. Comes off his right again, Callum Serka. Nice feet. And he's got a double. He stood up late in this first half and he showed his coach what he's made of.
He's coming back from injury, Callum Serka. A lot of respect and regard around his name, and this is why, again, just showing how lethal he can be out wide. This time hits the what's called the 1-2 gap inside the outside defender. Really good attack. Stop, start again. That little bit of balance changed. Keeps his pace, running with his head up. Everything about it is great, apart from the dive. Bit of a flop there.
Yeah, I might need to work on that. But,
half time.
Certainly got all the pace in the world. It's a successful conversion that time from Will Edwards. So a Callum Serka double has given England a healthy lead here. They lead Uganda by 19 points to 7 at halftime.
Let's do what we're supposed to do. Easy. It's not going to be very easy. Swing them wide. We break in the middle. Please. Let the breaks be in them in the other ends. But and then the middle on the channel can break through.
But we will try to finish them. Okay. Three, two, one. Murillo.
When they're faffing around in the middle, just stay connected. That's all it is.
Giving them that step aside. Just stay inside and
attack wise, excellent. Just keep working on those streets.
Let's go, boys.
Really
go
good boys.
Boys, let's go.
With our kickoffs, let's keep going for faster. Great effort, keep it on.
Big effort, boys. Another seven.
Smart,
fairly satisfied, Simon Amor with some last second instructions to his young England team. Big year ahead for many of the teams in the top tier of sevens coming up. We've got 10 events on the World Series kicking off in Dubai in December. There's a Commonwealth Games on the Gold Coast in Australia. That's a week before the Hong Kong Sevens. And then a World Cup in San Francisco in July. So managing squads, managing players is going to be really, really important for the likes of Simon Amor in England. We're back underway. Uganda opened the scoring in this Pool B match in the first half, but England have responded with three tries, a couple to Callum Serka and the captain, Will Edwards, picking up another.
When to clear out, when to clear
it's
out.
Jordan Ainslie stealing a couple of metres there over on the far side, and England will put it through their hands once more. Perhaps started a little slowly in this game, but they seem to have found their feet. It's George Chatterton. He'll do a lot of the donkey work up the middle for England, making yards. So the speed men out wide can pick up points, but Uganda have turned it over here, and a chance for them to put some of this attacking flair that we saw in that first half into action. Here they come, the Cranes. Can't quite step through the line there. Good tackle from Spofforth. James Odongo flings it out to Fred Odoo, try scorer. There's Philip Wakarach with the show and go, and England had to be alert to that. Just brought the danger man down. Still alive for Uganda. There's the offload, and they're through. It's Odongo who goes under the posts, and that's high quality sevens from Uganda. They're right back in this Pool B contest.
Well, the instruction at halftime from Simon Amor there was about defence.
They're taking care of themselves, but again, too many missed tackles there. This Ugandan team can offload their big physical presences. They get their arms free and they support each other to the hilt. What a great score, a bit of a team effort. Again, transfer of ball there, gripping it in one hand, short offload. Nice to see Odongo strolling, barely looking out of breath.
And the conversion successful from Wokerat. So 19-14, 5 points the difference. 5 minutes to go in this game. Slightly wobbly restart there from Uganda, but it's come off for them. I'm not sure that was the intention, but it had a bit of the banana around it, that one, and fell into Ugandan hands.
Knock on.
Pass going to ground, and that's a knock-on, says the referee. So they got a bit of luck off the, kick-off, but
scrum white.
End up spilling it.
Yeah, those tiny little errors, often frustrating. Simon Amor now looking to bring on Ethan Waddleton, the most experienced member of this squad.
You are, lads.
Yeah, played 12 events on the World Series. Waddleton, he's back from injury as well. Got injured at the Hong Kong Sevens, didn't play again on the series last year, so good to see him back. He really is a workhorse, a real find for Simon Amor out of the Northampton and then
Crouch.
More recently the Saracens Academy.
Bind. Set.
So Will Edwards will feed this scrum just on the England side of halfway. Buy themselves a little bit of space. And that's Ryan Oluwafela, yep, who's come off the bench for England.
In a turnover.
And that's a good turnover. Scrum. As old Oluwafela went to deck.
It's a solid hit. Wokeresh puts the right shoulder in. Oluwafela felt it. Not a small man, but great turnover work. The Ugandan breakdown skills have been excellent this game.
Subs.
Very talented squash player in his youth was Ryan Oluwafela, and Simon Amor tells me that he can get some of that lunging and lateral movement ability and transfer that to the game of sevens. He could be a really handful, but he perhaps could have used it on that occasion.
It's a shame the listeners at home didn't see your efforts of trying to shuffle there. That was excellent.
Something's the best only listen to, Rob Vickerman. 19-14, 3.5 minutes left in this Pool B match. England with possession. Oluwafela has it once more. Tries to get the handoff going. Does get the offload going. Here's Fergus Geary inside. He tried to find Oluwafela, but it went over his head. And it's fallen into the hands of Brian Kakawa. So Uganda just 5 points behind here. Waddleton tried to counter-ruck, but Uganda held on to it. Wokerat coming into the game now, isn't he? The danger man for Uganda. Finds the offload
another
there.
Another turnover. He went forward trying to regather. Scrum down.
He'll scrum it down to the Ugandans. Wokerat, he seems to have woken up a bit here, doesn't he?
Yeah, first half just a pivot play, really. Standing first receiver and passing the ball quite wide, but definitely a threat with the ball in hand for sure. Shame on Offler, I couldn't get the ball there. He's one of these players you mentioned that always gets himself there, thereabouts. Saw him play in the Premiership Sevens a few times domestically. He's handy, and you can see here Waddleton alongside him, not scared of getting stuck into the breakdowns.
Ethan Waddleton a little surprised at the decision there, but we play on. Uganda have the ball. And here's Wokerat. Shares the run around that time with Okorach, not to be confused. And Uganda just over 2 minutes left, trying to find something. This would be a big scalp to beat England. First up here at the Oktoberfest Sevens, they got the penalty. And Ramazan Govle just surveys his options. One of the more experienced players in this Ugandan outfit. Show and go on the near side, and that ball's gone forward again. So England have it. Here's Will Edwards, the captain. But that's turned over again. So
work for scrum.
Neither team seems to be able to hold on to the ball here, Rob.
No, interesting reaction there. Okorash was so frustrated at the knock-on that he stopped, put his arms up, and then realised the play was still going on. So managed to get back and win the ball back for his team, but sadly not enough advantage there from the English knock-on.
Callum Sirka breathing very deeply indeed.
Crouch.
two tries in the first half. He's taken his place over on the far wing.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
So England with the scrum, just on their side of halfway. Edwards feeds it. All a fella to Circa. Circa steps off his left, back inside. England keeping the ball alive. They lead this game by 5 points. Waddleton picks up the bounce pass. A little bit messy from England again. Follow a fella.
Release red!
A little bit high into contact back. There again. He's shoved back, but England hold on to the ball. Fergus Geary across to Edwards. He's the playmaker in midfield, and he can play. Edwards goes the step now. Looks to pop it up and does so. That's Ben Howard, and Howard's away. That's how you do it, England. You give it to your skipper. He'll use his feet. He'll find the support. But Benny Howard's got a score.
There's the class of Will Edwards on show here. Lovely step, beats the inside defence, still looking, scanning, bit of a hitch kick, again change of direction, just sucking players in, and what a support line there. Ben Howard knows full well, if you run back at the ball, you get opportunity.
Out of the Worcester Warriors, Ben Howard. Another player that Simon Amor's quite excited about, tall, rangy winger. Really good support play from him. And he gets his first score here in Munich for the England Sevens. It's full-time in Pool B, and England have won it by 26 points to 14. Here's a few of the facts from that first half. Tackles missed, 10 for Uganda. That hurt them in the end. Passes completed were pretty even throughout. Both teams giving the ball away six times. That's quite high in a game of sevens. OK, let's go sideline with Simon Amor.
Congratulations on that first win there, Simon. How important is it for the youngsters in this squad to get the opportunity to gain experience in sevens?
Oh, it is absolutely everything. When we're looking at some of these guys playing in the World Series this year, the opportunity to play here at a great tournament and test themselves, it's a very good Uganda team. They kept the ball alive and moved us around a lot. So really hard work for them, but so proud of the effort they put in there. Lots to learn and lots to improve upon, but the effort was excellent.
In the context of the season, how important is this tournament?
Oh, it's massive. In terms of these young guys, instead of throwing them straight into the World Series and saying sink or swim, the ability to play something here against some top-level teams is excellent. So, delighted to be here.
Well done.
Thanks.